It's been a while since I've done one of these, so today we're going to look at 10 more tips and tricks to help you edit faster in Final Cut Pro. Let's get right into it. If you have long clips in your media browser with only a few highlights you want to use in your project, you can break these long clips up into smaller chunks with only the parts you need. Just skim your clip in the media browser, and when you get to the part you want to use, use the I and O keys to select a range in your clip with a highlight. Press F on your keyboard to mark this range as favorite. Repeat this for any other highlights in your long clip, favoriting as many ranges as you need. When you switch your clip view to favorites, either by selecting it from the drop-down menu or using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl F, each range you favorited shows up as its own clip. This makes finding your highlights way easier. When you're working on a project, sometimes it can be very helpful to know what clips or parts of clips you've already used. To mark clips that are used in your project, go up to the menu bar and select View, Browser, and make sure Used Media Ranges are selected. Now, whatever clips you used in your project are marked with an orange line at the bottom for easy reference. You can combine this with the clips you favorited in the last step and make a super useful Unused Favorites Smart Collection. Press Option Command N to make a new smart collection and give it a name. Let's call ours Unused Favorites. Double-click on the Smart Collection, and let's add some rules. We want to filter the clips that match all our criteria, so make sure all is selected on the left-hand side. Click the plus button on the right-hand side, select Ratings, and make sure Favorites are selected. This filters down the Smart Collection to only clips we marked as favorite. Now, let's add another rule, select Used Media, and change this filter to Unused. This filters out all the clips we marked as favorites that haven't been used in our project yet. Super handy. This next tip has saved me a ton of time. Whenever I need to put together a video and either don't have the time or I'm stuck in a creative rut, I always turn to Premade Timelines from Motion VFX, who is today's sponsor. These are basically projects already made for you, with cuts in the right places, titles, effects, and much more. Let me show you. After purchasing a timeline, open the M Installer tool, pick the timeline you want to use, and click Open in FCP. Select your aspect ratio and frame rate, click Run, and pick a library you want to open it in. All you have left to do is add your own video clips and replace the text in the included titles. Just grab a clip from your media browser and drag it over one of the gap clips in your timeline. To keep the timing of your project, select either Replace from Start or Replace from End. Replace from Start will keep the start point of your selection and cut off the end to match the length of the gap clip. Replace from End does the exact opposite. If you need to adjust what part of the clip is used, press T to switch to the trim tool and perform a slip edit by dragging your clip left or right. Final Cut Pro Timelines from Motion VFX even comes with a couple of choices of music tracks for reference. If you want to share your projects online, you can either license these tracks or replace them with your own tracks with the same tempo. Trust me, using timelines from Motion VFX will save you a ton of time. And honestly, most of the time, you end up with a video much better than what you would make from scratch. And during checkout, if you use the promo code TIMELINE33, you get 33% off any timeline you buy. Try one out, you're gonna love it. While on the topic of timelines, if you build title cards, end screens, or any other effects in your project, and want to use them in another project, you don't have to build them from scratch again. Just make a new project, and use Option W to add a gap clip to your timeline. Make this gap clip nice and long. Copy all the elements you used to build your effect and paste them into this project. Now, whenever you need to add the same elements, come back to this project and copy and paste all your clips. No more searching for titles and lining up sound effects to match up with your clips. If you find yourself styling all your titles the same way across all your projects, once again, you don't need to manually do it every time. Add a title to your project and adjust it to look exactly the way you want. This includes size, color, and any other effects you apply to your text, like a drop shadow or an outline. Now, to save all these as a text preset, scroll up to the top of your text inspector, open the Styles drop-down menu, and select Save All Format and Appearance Attributes. Give it a name and click Save. Next time you need to format your title, instead of going through all the steps again, just open the Styles drop-down and select your preset. Way faster and easier. When you have effects or adjustments applied to a clip in your timeline, and you want to apply the same to other clips, there are a few easy ways of doing this. If you're on Final Cut Pro 10.8 or later, you can grab your effect, or a number of effects in the inspector, and just drag and drop them over another clip to apply them. Super easy. If you haven't updated yet, or want to copy over effects and any adjustments you made to your clip, like using the transform tool to reframe it, select your clip with the effects, and press Command-C to copy it. Select the clip you want to apply these effects to, and press Shift-Command-V to paste the attributes. In the pop-up window, select the attributes you want to paste, and click the Paste button. If you want to copy over all the adjustments, you can skip this step and press Option-Command-V to paste all attributes. With the Final Cut Pro 10.8 update, we got a number of new features, one of the bigger ones being enhanced light and color. With this, Final Cut Pro analyzes your clip and uses machine learning to help improve the exposure and colors in your clip. This actually works really well and is much faster and easier than color correcting manually. To apply this to your clip, open the Enhancements drop-down menu and select Enhance Light and Color. Final Cut Pro analyzes your clip and adds all the necessary adjustments. Now, unlike the Balance Color option we had previously, you can fine-tune these adjustments. When you go to your color inspector, you can see all the adjustments Final Cut Pro made to your clip. You can toggle these on and off, toggle the light and color adjustments individually, or manually fine-tune each parameter to get it looking just the way you want. If you've been following my channel, you probably know you can make a custom audio folder, and every music or sound effect file you add to that folder automatically shows up in Final Cut Pro. While you can't make a folder like that for video files, you can do the same thing with the Apple TV app. This is great for things like overlays or stock video clips, something you want to show up in every library you make without having to manually import these files every time. First, go into your settings and make sure Copy Files to Media folder is selected. Now, when you download any stock video clips, overlays, or any file you want to use across multiple libraries, just drag and drop it into the TV app. Since these files are copied and stored inside the TV app, you can go ahead and delete the originals. To access these in Final Cut Pro, go to your audio and video sidebar and select Apple TV. All your clips will be in here, no matter what library you have open. If there's a tool or a setting in Final Cut Pro you know is there, but you can't remember where to find it, instead of pointlessly clicking around, use the Help menu. For example, if you want to turn on Use Media Ranges, but don't remember where it is, just go to the Help menu and start typing. Hovering over the tool or setting you're looking for will tell you exactly where to find it. This is also really handy if you're trying to learn how to do something in Final Cut Pro. For example, if you need to know how to synchronize your audio and your video clips, just go to the Help menu and start typing. Clicking on a topic will take you to the Final Cut Pro user guide that explains exactly what you need to do. If you're a Final Cut Pro user, which I'm assuming you are since you made it this far into the video, you know how fast Final Cut Pro libraries can grow. If your library is starting to get too big, one way to shrink it is by deleting all the render files. Select your library in the media browser, go up to the menu bar, click File, and delete generated library files. In the pop-up window, select Delete Render Files and All. None of these render files are necessary. Final Cut Pro just makes them for smoother playback, but you'll be amazed at how much smaller your library is after this. I hope at least one of these tips was new to you. If it was, let me know which one in the comments below. And for more Final Cut Pro tips and tricks, I put together a short playlist. Click right here to watch it, and I'll see you over there.